We're also going to encourage you to release your own spirit and soul. We're going to encourage you to speak out. We're going to encourage you to shout what's within you, to share with others what we bring to the table. That also helps to heal. That helps to deal with the traumas that we experience. Now, I have to admit, some of the trauma we experience is self-inflicted trauma. It's our ideas, our beliefs, our fears. And part of the reason we come together is so that we can share those fears, those anxieties, whether it's with the brother or the sister right next to you, or whether it's the brother or the sister across the way. When you put out your fear, it gets dispersed and shared among the spirits and souls and power of everybody here. So we're going to encourage that, all right? We're also going to encourage that you participate, that you move. We're going to have some physical activities for you to do and some spiritual activities. We're going to have meditation and hope you engage in that. We're going to have massage. Hope you engage in that. We're going to do some movement and yoga and want you to engage in that. We're going to have some singing, some sharing of ideas and want you to engage in that. I just want to introduce myself. My name is Abner Bowles, and I am blessed that on a regular basis, Ms. Williams allows me to come and to meet with all of you and participate in this event. And it's especially important for me tonight because this week I lost my best friend, and that is a very major trauma to me personally and me in my life. So having the opportunity to share that with all of you and to feel the healing and the spirit that you bring tonight, it means a lot to me. And so I want to thank you for that. Now I want to bring her over for her to sort of do some introduction.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Today is our sixth Family Empowerment Summit, but I wanted to tell you a little bit about the Western Addition Wellness Coalition. We started out dealing with the violence that has permeated this community for years and years, and I run an after-school program where I work with the youth. I call them my babies. I don't care how old they are. But I noticed that most of them have attention deficit disorder, traumatized babies. And then I came and I started living in the midst of these people, and I understand. These babies have been exposed to so much violence, and the bummer is it's generational. Their parents experience violence, their grandparents experienced violence, and then here they are. So what amazed me, I'm looking up at City Hall one day, and a pediatrician from San Francisco General came up and put two slides, brain scans, of 2 3-year-old babies. One baby had not been exposed to domestic or community violence, and one baby had been exposed to domestic and community violence. And what freaked me out was that there was a difference in the brain scan. And Dr. Abner can explain this more, but it tripped me out because I was a psychology major, and I remember us debating whether it was environmental or biological. To say that trauma can change your brain, and that part of the brain that loves, have empathy, sympathy. It freaked me out. I was also on the mental health board and noticed that they weren't really dealing with this trauma that the babies were experiencing. So, and Dr. was my cohort here. We were both on the mental health board, and we started talking about the impact of trauma on our kids, especially underserved kids of color, who are constantly surrounded by, in their environment, by violence. So we started out dealing with that. And then we had our first summit, got some feedback, and found out that not only are the babies traumatized, but the parents and the community as a whole is traumatized. And post-traumatic shock is what it is with these babies and with the community. And now on top of that, we got craziness in our leadership in Washington, D.C., where since I was a kid, I never thought about the nuclear bombing. And where are the shelters now? I grew up with bomb shelters. And so you got all that weighing on you, the possibility of being homeless in this expensive city where only the rich can live. You have all these things that are weighing on your mind. And so that's why we're here. And we want to do it on a regular basis where we can bring the community together and we can explore this and we can be here with love and caring. And so we had five of these summits. We had one youth summit last summer with the babies, just with the kids. And we intend to do that again this summer. So that's why we're here. And that's why you're going to continue to see the Western Vision Coalition doing these family empowerment summits. Because we can do something about it. We can reinforce each other and love each other. So without further ado, I also do Kwanzaa each year. And it really revives me each year because Kwanzaa is all about blackness, community, family. And so I made a promise at Kwanzaa that I was going to continue that feeling throughout the year where we do honor our ancestors, we do pour libations. And so I'm going to bring up Ms. Fatima to pour libations, and then we'll proceed with the program. But thank you for coming out. My name is Adrian Williams. I run the Village Project, and it's my priority is supposed to be the babies, but you can't do babies without doing family, so that's why we're here. Thank you.